you want to learn about your family heritage. And what better way than DNA testing? Except, there could be a downside. Like, who gets access to your DNA? Welcome to America Uncovered. I'm Chris Chappell. Remember to subscribe and click the bell icon so you get notified next time we upload a video. Millions of people are curious about their ancestry. They want to learn a little bit more about their family history. And what better way to do that than sending a sample of your DNA to some big company with friendly videos?
Did you know you can learn a whole lot more about what's in your genes by comparing your results to others?
Yeah, just spit into a tube. Cheers. Then send it off to a lab somewhere and get your results back in 6 to 8 weeks. That video is from 23andMe. It's one of the two biggest genealogy companies in the US. The other big one is Ancestry.
Our expansive record collections and growing network of family trees have helped our members make billions of meaningful connections.
Both of them are also frequent sponsors of popular YouTube channels. So 23andMe, Ancestry, and several others, they've acquired a huge collection of human DNA. An estimated 7 million Americans have taken a DNA test, and worldwide, it's more than 26 million. Even the Grinch took a DNA test in this delightful example of product placement. Now we finally know what race the Grinch was meant to be. Just kidding, you do not want to know what race Dr. Seuss meant for the Grinch to be. It will destroy your childhood. 23andMe was careful to stick to less controversial genetics.
Says here, loving salty snacks is in my DNA. True.
I mean, if it weren't for 23andMe, how could the Grinch possibly know he loves salty snacks? But there are genuinely good things that have come out of consumer-based DNA tests. For some people, the results can be a great boost to their ego.
Listen up, I'm a gene that impacts your muscle composition.
Do you even have ACTN3, bro? For others, they've credited DNA companies with helping them diagnose medical conditions. The tests tell you if you're genetically at risk for different diseases, like Alzheimer's or breast cancer. The FDA has approved them to give you certain medical results, but their methods are disputed. Some of the tests may be more like parlor tricks than medicine. Other people take DNA tests to find out more about their family heritage. You can find long-lost relatives. But like all good things, there's a catch. For starters, the results can be a lot to unpack. Here's what happened to Eugene from Try Guys in a video sponsored by 23andMe.
You are not 100% Korean. You are 19.9% Japanese.
19.9. My parents will be furious.
Or imagine if your father had another child that no one else knew about. Or if you find out that your father is not really your father. And whether your results are good or bad or chaotic neutral, they're made possible because genealogy companies like Ancestry and 23andMe have collected a treasure trove of data from millions of people. DNA testing really started taking off in 2017. And in 2018, as many people purchased consumer DNA kits as in all previous years combined. That's largely because the costs have gone down dramatically. Now you can get a DNA testing kit for less than $100. And as prices drop, and these companies keep sponsoring YouTube channels and Dr. Seuss characters, DNA testing will only get more popular. The MIT Technology Review estimates that a total of 100 million people will have tried a DNA home testing kit by 2021. I don't know about you, but to me, that sounds like a gold mine of personal data. And I know a couple of guys who really love that stuff. Now, a giant corporation getting access to your personal data is already scary enough. What about the police? It turns out your trusted law enforcement could be navigating the very same databases you willingly submitted your DNA into. More and more, we're seeing cold cases of rape and murder getting retroactively solved with the help of DNA database matching systems. It's happening across the country. Maryland, Florida, Alabama, and California. The case of the Golden State Killer is the most high-profile example of police using a genealogy database in action. Just over a year ago, investigators identified Joseph DeAngelo as the man they say is responsible for killing and raping dozens of people and burglarizing over 100 homes across the state in the 1970s and 80s. They cracked the case with the help of an online genealogy database called GEDmatch. It's an open-sourced website that hosts raw genetic information. The information is uploaded voluntarily by people who are actively looking for long-lost relatives. The lead investigator in the Golden State Killer case said he spent about 7 years using open-source genealogy-based websites to find the culprit. Eventually, D'Angelo's distant relatives uploaded their DNA to the database, and that's what led authorities to D'Angelo, although he hasn't been convicted. Here's another case that was cracked using GEDmatch, where the suspect's DNA was matched through a relative on the site, a relative who also presumably had a terrible mullet. Now you might say this is great. We're catching criminals who've evaded justice for decades. But just think about it for a second. They were caught through the DNA of relatives. They never willingly gave their DNA for testing. Well, except for the DNA they presumably left behind at the crime scenes. Now you might wonder whether police need a warrant to do this kind of stuff. Technically, they do. But at least one genealogy company, Family Tree DNA, is just handing over access to federal prosecutors. Over 2 million genetic profiles were exposed in this deal. Your private genetic information may not be so private anymore. John Verdi is the Vice President of Policy at the Future Privacy Forum, a DC-based think tank that focuses on data privacy. He's deeply concerned about this. He said the deal between Family Tree DNA and the FBI is deeply flawed, out of line with industry best practices, and out of line with consumer expectations. Most consumers expect their data to remain private, but not every company sees it that way. The operator of GEDmatch, Curtis Rogers, told the Mercury News that user profiles might be used for non-genealogical uses, and if users are concerned about their privacy, they should take their data down or avoid uploading their DNA in the first place. But it's a little bit unfair to provide a service for one purpose and then expect customers to understand that their data will be used for a completely different purpose. I mean, Facebook. To be fair, recently GEDmatch updated its website so that before you sign on, you can read through their 8-page Terms of Service and Privacy Policy. On page 5, there's a part that says possible uses of raw data include blah blah blah, familial searching by third parties such as law enforcement agencies. So obviously, every user will read the terms of service thoroughly and make an informed decision. On the other hand, I think it would be better if they just told you up front that they're going to share your DNA with the police. So are all genetic testing companies working with law enforcement to solve crimes? Not necessarily. Some companies have come out and denied claims their databases are used to solve crimes. 23andMe and Ancestry both said they don't work with law enforcement unless they receive a court order. A spokeswoman for 23andMe told the Washington Times that the company has never turned over customer data to law enforcement. And a spokeswoman for Ancestry said the company doesn't share data with insurance carriers, employers, or third-party marketers, and that law enforcement only gets access through a court-ordered warrant. I wonder, though, why some law enforcement agencies still won't disclose exactly which database they're using to crack crimes. Above all, it's disturbing to know that people can be identified through DNA services without having ever consented to it because of a relative being in the database. I mean, we all have that crazy uncle who may or may not have committed grand larceny and caused $32,000 worth of property damage. And does Uncle Nick really deserve to go to jail? Well, that saliva you spit into a tube may be just what authorities need to finally catch him. And then, who's going to give you weird and slightly inappropriate Christmas gifts next year? But seriously, there are going to be people who say, "What's the big deal? I don't have anything to hide." And that might be true, as long as we're living in a free and democratic society. But not every free and democratic society stays that way forever. What if one day your country becomes more authoritarian? China's authoritarian regime is already using DNA to spy on people. So having your DNA out there could come back to bite you. And here are three companies that have acknowledged they actively share genetic information with US law enforcement: GEDmatch, Family Tree DNA, and Parabon Nano Labs. Those are just the ones we know about right now. Back when the Golden State Killer story first broke, investigators didn't say which sites they had been working with. So who knows which companies are doing what until they get called out for it. It just goes to show that, like all private information, even your DNA kits are not so private when in the hands of a company that's being irresponsible or under pressure from law enforcement. And if that's news to you, you must be new here. Hi. But look at the bright side. If it weren't for 23andMe, how would we know the Grinch likes salty snacks?
True.
So what do you think about DNA testing companies? Have you taken a DNA test yourself? Leave your comments below. And this video has been sponsored by 23andMe. Just kidding. It's not easy to get sponsorship from large corporations when I call out the shady behavior of large corporations. That's why America Uncovered relies on support from viewers like you, who contribute through the crowdfunding website Patreon. Visit patreon.com/AmericaUncovered to support this show by joining our team and pledging $1 or more per episode. Once again, I'm Chris Chappell. Thanks for watching America Uncovered.